primary mandate of the district attorney is to ensure public safety and the equal administration of justice for all. Consistent with that mandate, approximately 1 hour ago, my office filed a civil lawsuit against the city of Sacramento, alleging that it violated California Civil Code Section 3480. Specifically, that it allowed, created, and enabled a public safety crisis regarding our unhoused. Now, you might be asking yourself, how did we get here? Why is the district attorney suing the city of Sacramento, and what comes next? So how did we get here? In the last 7 years, our unhoused population in Sacramento has exploded to over 250%. We have more homeless people in Sacramento than in San Francisco. The community is at a breaking point. The unhoused are living in conditions typical of third world countries. All the while, the rest of the community is stuck between compassion and chaos. So how did we get here? Earlier this summer, the presiding judge sent a letter. And that letter precipitated and started the process. But how did we get here? Let me put on my law professor hat for a moment and explain it this way. If you own private property, you allow drug dealing, drug use, if you allow human trafficking, theft, vandalism, if you allow the accumulation of garbage, needles, and feces on your property, the city of Sacramento will reach out to you and say, you know what, you need to clean this up because you are creating and allowing and enabling a public nuisance on your property. If you do little or nothing at all, the city will then send out a survey to your neighbors asking how your property affected their quality of life. And if you do little or nothing, at that point the city will send you a letter and tell you to do A, B, and C. Or they will take you to court and the judge will make you do A, B, or C. So what we are doing is we are simply holding the city accountable by the same laws that they enforce on us. So how did we get here? I had mentioned a moment ago the letter by the presiding judge of the Superior Court in which he sent to the city in detail public safety issues that impacted access to justice to the courthouse. The very next morning, I sent a letter to the city describing incidents where DA employees were threatened and assaulted. I asked for help from the city to get people off the streets and into shelter. The mayor responded by saying, the district attorney and the presiding judge are right. I'm going to fix this problem in 2 weeks. That was nearly 3 months ago. Since then, things have only gotten worse. Another court reporter was assaulted. Another DA employee was threatened. And just last night, at 3 o'clock in the morning, there were some bushes right outside the courthouse that was set on fire by an unhoused individual. How did we get here? We are stuck in this never-ending Groundhog Day loop where nothing gets better and nothing improves. How did we get here? Enough is enough. And so on July the 18th, 2023, my office sent out a survey regarding 16 major encampments within the city of Sacramento. We asked the community to describe in this survey how these encampments and the city's actions or inactions affected their quality of life. The responses were heart-wrenching. After nearly 3,000 responses that we received, my office sent the mayor a letter asking the city to do a few simple things. One, consistently enforce the law. Enforce the city ordinances that they put on the books regarding unlawful camping, unlawful storage, unlawful fire, and sidewalk obstructions. Two, to create additional safe ground sites that are professionally operated. Three, City Hall allows camping on City Hall property at night, but they don't allow it during the day. I asked the city to extend the same protection they give to themselves to the rest of us. Four, to complete the audit that they started 2 years ago. An audit that really evaluates the millions upon millions of dollars that have been spent to deal with the unhoused crisis. And a true accounting of what program actually works. 2 years ago, that process started, and we still have little to nothing to show for it. And five, I've asked the city to share real-time data in regards to the availability of shelter beds to all the partners, including to law enforcement. To date, the city has not fully implemented any of these proposals. So how did we get here? 7 years into this descent into decay, 7 years into this collapse into chaos, where we have an erosion of everyday life. An erosion of everyday life where we forget what it feels like to be safe. And that brings us to this lawsuit, or should I say lawsuits. So, why is the district attorney suing the city of Sacramento? Because we need to get people off the streets. Living on the streets is not compassionate for the unhoused or the housed. Studies show that 9 out of 10 women who are chronically homeless are victims of sexual assault. Sacramento Sheriff Jim Cooper, since January, has been conducting homeless outreach and enforcement in the unincorporated area, found nearly 600 incidents of sexual assault, nearly 500 incidents of domestic violence. They visited and cleaned up over 400 different camps. It's not safe. It's not safe for the unhoused or the housed. Earlier this summer, in the middle of the heat wave, I was driving downtown on the corner of 15th and J. I saw an unhoused woman hopping around barefoot on the sizzling sidewalk before she ran off into the streets. Is it compassionate to let people die in the sweltering summer sun? Is it compassionate to let people freeze to death on a cold winter's night? Is it compassionate that we allow unsafe conditions to fester so that a 14-year-old boy can't ride his bike to school, or little girls can't play soccer on a field littered with needles? Is it compassionate that somebody in a wheelchair cannot navigate down the street because of blocked tents, or small businesses have to shut down forever because of repeated broken windows and break-ins? Why is the district attorney suing the city of Sacramento? Because we are giving a voice. We are giving a voice to those that feel as if their cries for help have fallen on deaf ears. You see them up here with me today. You see them here in the audience. And I bet you if we had a bigger location, we'd have even more people here who yearn to have their voices heard. I want to tell you a moment about Sandy. Sandy, 30 years ago, bought a beautiful little home with her husband in the blue-collar neighborhood of Colonial Heights. Together, Sandy and her husband raised a family and built a life for themselves in that home. A few years ago, Sandy's husband passed away, but she kept going. Family members and friends passed away, but she kept going. And then cancer came knocking on her door. But Sandy kept going until there was an unhoused encampment that opened up across the street from her. She reported a drug dealer, and so every day that drug dealer would walk by her house with a leather whip and crack it as he stared menacingly at her. She reported broken condoms and prostitution, but the city let it fester. She reported feces and urine, but the city let it fester. And the cries for help that Sandy had went unanswered. And in fact, the people from the camp threatened to burn down her home. They shot out her window with a BB gun. When Sandy's son moved in to help her out, the people from the camp went up to the son and said, "If you leave, we're going to rape your mother." So in the midst of fighting cancer, Sandy actually moved out of her house to another part of town and rented a room. She told us that, "You know, my husband passing away didn't break me. Cancer didn't break me, but this homeless encampment broke me." The city of Sacramento has not heard Sandy's voice, but they will now, because she's listed as one of the victims in the people's complaint. But you know what? There are other people that feel as if their voices, their community's voices, have not been heard by the city.